Barry and Leanne, and I wasn't going to do any filming. Leanne and I just wanted to get away and kind of enjoy a week of the backcountry ourselves here, but we're running about 7,000 feet here, and it's pretty cool. And it's just amazing just watching the clouds vacuum down here. Just one of the other aesthetic beauties of this fantastic area that we're in. So I'll just zoom in just a little bit so you could see it. It's just amazing how there is a mountain behind there, and it'll come into picture in just a minute. So I'm gonna hang tough and hopefully it won't rain on me, but these clouds are just vacuuming down. Absolutely a beautiful thing. I'm surrounded by palm trees. Just look at it come down here. Surrounded by palm trees, and then there's pine trees and there's birch, and it's really cold, and there it is on the road. Look at it come down to the road, the cloud behind us. Isn't that absolutely incredibly beautiful? And I'll zoom back just so you can get, and just absolutely amazing. I'm gonna hang on to this just for a little while longer. And I guess it's just one of the things that never ceases to amaze me here. For those of you, you know, the type of folks that aren't afraid to get out and maybe pick up a bit of Espanol, you know, and un dos palabras de Espanol, and get out and visit this magnificent country. It's all these years, and I'm still amazed every time there's something new like this that comes around, that I had the opportunity to be in a vacuum just off this mountain road, about 40 miles out of Costanza. I've never been on through here but one time, and I can't emphasize it enough. We just drove for about 3 hours, and all we saw in 3 hours is nothing but food. Everything from cabbages, Roma tomatoes, delicious apples, onions, broccoli, cabbage, pepino is cucumber in English, and so many wonderful things here. So I'm going to move on down here just a little bit more, but I really wanted, now you could see the trees in the background, and my gosh, I really just don't know how it gets any more beautiful than this. And it'll sweep one more time. I'll just go a little bit higher so you can see it, and I hope you all appreciate this, and it's just absolutely magnificent. And anyway, you know, I'm not going to do much filming on this trip. I want to just relax with my wife. Yeah, I just had to stop here and do this one more time at an opening. Really beautiful. I'm sitting here, probably a few hundred yards from where I filmed the first part. And I just wanted to, believe it or not, we're up another 100 feet, so we're around 7,500 feet. And I just wanted to give you an idea of the clouds rolling in across this open area. I just thought it was absolutely beautiful, and I really wanted to give, you know, our subscribers a look at this. Leanne's yelling, stop the car, stop the car. And she's out there doing some pictures, and she just said it was fantastic. We had to do this, so I wanted to make sure that we got it on film for you. And it's just, it's a little opening here. Nothing special about it, except the fact that it's just amazing. I mean, you see the clouds rolling in, and you don't even see the trees behind it, and then you see the trees a little bit, and then you see them clearly, and just really super. I've seen this once or twice, but I never did actually film it, so I wanted to be sure I got this on film. I think it's really cool, and hope you guys do too. And we're here last week of August, and it gets busy for us. with some folks coming pretty much all through September and October. And just said goodbye to some great folks, two beautiful couples, and looking forward to getting a chance to meet a whole bunch more of you. And we're really glad that everybody that comes out here happens to just love how we demonstrate the country. Because it's a shame, but most people don't capture the absolute beauty of this country the way it should be done. And I'm just doing a kind of a spin around here. I'm not breaking out all the equipment. Because, like I said, Leanne and I just wanted a little bit of time to ourselves. But this was definitely worth stopping and doing a view of it. It's absolutely beautiful. My gosh, I love this place. Anyway, Barry and Leanne out for now, and we'll be back somewhere in civilization in about 6 days. Well, good morning. This is Barry here, and I'm on day 3 of our vacation time here. And we had to take a stop. We did pull into Jarabacoa, which is where I am now. And we are at one of our favorite stops here. And I'm filming from my porch balcony. We nicknamed this spot over the years, Leanne and I, 214, 215, because either in room 214 or 215, filming, this is right off my balcony here where we're staying, because we got rained out. There's an investment here that's out in the Atlantic, and it's causing a little bit of havoc with the weather. And because of that, where we wanted to go, I was really going to take a little bit more serious of a back road here, 4x4. But the issue is there's some slopes that lead to pretty dramatic drop-offs. And when I say pretty dramatic, I mean drop-offs that would be in the neighborhood of around 3,000 feet if you miss. And by it getting muddy, there's no guardrails or anything, and it's a straight drop right off it. So with that in mind, obviously, I had to put that on hold, and I don't even think I'm going to be able to get to it, because it's going to take at least a couple of days to dry off. So I'm going to be here in Jarabacoa. That's the only reason I'm even filming, because the rain is kind of sombered this four-wheel extended cruise here. Now, we were 9.5 hours yesterday back roading, and it was just phenomenal. This is not a bad place at all to stay, don't get me wrong, and I just love this room. But I'm gonna search around and find some mild trails, you know, flat road 4x4, where there could be some dips and what have you, but plenty of space. If you run off the road, you're not going down a 5,000 foot cliff, because even with the best kind of vehicle, mud, especially when it's mixed with clay, all you guys that enjoy getting off the road would know what I'm talking about. Even when mud's mixed with clay, it's damn near black ice. And so no chances like that. And I just thought I'd give you guys a quick sweep. We're gonna head into town and enjoy ourselves a little bit around town, get a couple of supplies, I guess. And I hope this comes out, because it's a pretty dark day here. Anyway, I just thought I'd keep you a little bit current with us as to what's going on here. I guess can't help but, you know, once in a while, gotta be me. I guess we're toughing it out in what, you know, many Westerners say, you're living in a third world country. Well, yes, we are. And all of this, including a huge buffet, get your start breakfast kind of thing with everything you can imagine on it. A room like this, and it's beautiful inside with this kind of view, it's running about $80 a day. So I'll back up, give you an idea of the size of the deck I'm on, and unfortunately, that's how life is sometimes. The best of intentions, the four-wheel driving will have to take a back seat for now, but as you can see, this isn't so bad. And coming up September and October, we're really booked solid. And we're hoping, gosh, we're getting a lot of people to see our kind of views about how life is actually better in so many of these countries. And I'm so glad we're getting our point across. Anyway, just thought I'd film off the deck a little bit and we'll go from there. This is good old Barry in DR here. Have a great day. Bye.
Hopefully one day we'll be seeing you here. And until next time, this is Barry and Leanne for Something Feels Wrong and DR Escapes. Until next time. Bye.